What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com where we make learning PL SQL fun. Now that we have learned the concepts of nested table and VARRAY type collection in the previous tutorial, thus today we will jump on to the next type of collection, which is associative array. But first, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe and don't forget to like this video as it keeps me motivated to continue doing my work, which is to help you by sharing the knowledge. Let's see if we can have 100 likes on this video. Okay, so that being said, let's move ahead. Unlike nested table and VARRAY, associative array hold elements of similar data type in key value pairs. Nature of associative array is non-persistent, which means neither the array nor the data can be stored in the database. Also, similar to the nested table, the associative array is also an unbounded collection, which means there is no upper bound on the number of elements it can hold. Let's do some examples and try to understand associative array in more detail. Now that we have set the server output on and started our PL SQL block, next we create the associative array. Remember that similar to nested table and VARRAY, you can only create the associative array inside the declaration section of the PL SQL block. Here, I have created an associative array with name books, which can hold elements of number data type. Till so far, the statement looks very similar to those statements which we use for creating VARRAY and nested table, right? But then we have an additional clause, which is index by, followed by a valid index data type. Using index type clause, we specify the data type of the associative array subscript. You can read more about syntax of associative array on my blog, whose link is in the description. Let's move ahead. Next, we will create an associative array variable. It will be used for referencing the associative array we just created. This array variable can be created very easily. You just have to write the name of the variable, which is user defined, followed by the name of the associative array. Let's do it. Here we have our array variable. I named it ISBN. Unlike other forms of collection, associative array does not require initialization and have no constructor syntax like these. Next, we will see how to insert values into the collection associative array. As I said before, in associative array, we store the data in key value pair. The value stored against the index, which signifies the data type of array subscript, will act as the key, whereas the data of number data type will be the value. Let's insert some data into the associative array. As you can see, using the array variable ISBN, we inserted two key value pairs into the associative array books. Inserting data into the array is easy, as there is no need to write insert into DML. Similarly, updating value is as easy as inserting them. If you want to change any value, write the same statement which is used for insertion with the modified values. For example, say you want to change the value against the key MySQL from 9876 to 1010. Then you just write. That's it. On execution, this will update the values for a specified key, which in this case is MySQL. Now that we have learned how to insert and update values of an associative array, next we will learn how to retrieve the values from it. Just like we don't need insert DML statement for inserting values or update DML for updating values, similarly we don't need select DML for retrieving values. See how easy it is? Let me show you. Suppose you want to see the value stored against the key Oracle database. For that, you just need to write. That's it. That single DBMS output statement is all you need. On execution, you will get your value. What am I waiting for? Let me execute this code for you. But for that, we have to first close this block with keyword and a forward slash. We are good to go. Let's execute. Here is the value 1234 stored against the key Oracle database. This is the case when you want to retrieve one specific value. What about if you want to retrieve all the values stored into the array? Any guesses? Yes, right. We will use the loop to retrieve all the values from the associative array. Let's modify this block and write the loop. But before that, let's close this output panel. I'll start with deleting this DBMS output statement. And it's done. For this demonstration, we will be using while loop. To use while loop, we will need a loop counter. Let's declare a scalar variable which can be used as a loop counter. Here we have our loop counter, which is of varchar 2 type. Now let's write the loop. Here is our loop. Right before the loop, I stored the first key into the loop counter. To do that, I used a collection method called first. This method will return the first index from our associative array. Then we have our while loop. Using the loop counter flag, we are making sure that this loop will run from the first index value, which we just stored into it, till it encounters any null value stored against any key. Inside this loop, we are printing the data stored as key and value in our associative array. The last statement of the loop is for increasing the counter to the next value after every iteration. If you are confused about the while loop and its working, then make sure to check out the PL SQL tutorial 12 where we discussed the same in detail. As always, link is in the description. So let's try to execute and see whether we can retrieve all the values stored into the associative array books or not. Here are all our data which we stored earlier into the array. So in this tutorial, we learned how to create an associative array, how to insert and update values of the associative array, and then we saw two different ways of retrieving values from it. Hope you enjoyed watching. You can head over to my blog for more in-depth knowledge of the concept. Do make sure to like and share. And if you are new to this channel, then smash that big red subscribe button. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.